The ninja, or more properly, the shinobi, is without question the most recognized and mythologized martial arts figure in the world. The very mention of this term conjures up the image of an iconic Japanese assassin, possessed of supernatural abilities, who could appear and disappear at will, survive any physical hardship, and always accomplish the mission, even if it meant the sacrifice of his own life. Most people consider the ninjas of old to be the antithesis of the noble samurai. While the samurai fought in open warfare for their lord, or dueled each other in matters of honor, the ninja has been cast in a far less noble role, that of a black-clad and ruthless killer who hides in the shadows and strikes without warning. Lacking Bushido, or a samurai's code of honor, the ninja uses trickery and deception, secret and exotic weapons, various poisons, and concealment tactics to accomplish the most sinister of objectives. But just how many of these common conceptions are accurate? Were all ninja actually despicable thieves or assassins, absent of an ethical code of honor? Were they actually possessed of supernormal abilities? And who, if anyone in today's world, would qualify as a modern-day equivalent of these ancient figures? To answer these questions, we've invited two highly respected scholar practitioners, Anthony Cummins and James Loriega, to help us understand the truth about the ninja and sort out fact from fiction. We'll also take a look at how the very idea of the ninja has permeated popular culture worldwide, in films, in advertising, and even in modern-day, real-life crimes. So join us now as we go in search of historical ninjutsu, this week on Martial Arts View. The word ninja derives from the term Shinobi no Mano, which means literally one who steals in, and refers to the ninja's primary role, the adoption of stealth tactics for espionage purposes. Contrary to popular thinking, the ninja was not strictly an assassin. Neither is ninjutsu a martial art in any real or organized sense. In fact, many of the techniques employed by the ninja were actually identical to the fighting arts used by the samurai. Indeed, many ninja throughout history were samurai or in their direct service. Although the exact origin of the shinobi remains unclear, it is generally thought that an organized, covert spy system evolved first in China, whose practitioners were masterful assassins targeting corrupt officials. Both the Ban Shenshukai and the Shonin Ki, two extant and widely referenced ninja documents, explicitly state that the beginnings of the ninja lay in ancient China. It is therefore possible that what we have come to know as a significant Japanese archetype may have been, at least initially, a figure of more Chinese origin. But one of the major problems, as we shall see, with tracing the history of a largely covert group of practitioners is that so little has been written down over the centuries. And what scrolls do exist can have a somewhat cryptic element, and therefore require careful and painstaking study. Less open to speculation is that the golden age of the shinobi in Japan, or the period of the most concentrated development of stealth, espionage, and weapons technique, was the pre-Edo era, before the year 1600, when warfare between clans was at its height. Constant warfare necessitated the need for intelligence gathering through embedded spies, disruption tactics, and even at times, frontline shock troops, roles which were often tasked to ninja operatives. The Edo period brought with it several hundred years of overall peace, and although many ninja films are set during this time, it is certain that such peace brought with it a relative decline in the need for the skill sets the ninja possessed. The regions of Koga and Iga, however, continued to train shinobi in the arts of stealth, espionage, intelligence gathering, the use of poisons, and many other disciplines which comprise the entire knowledge base of the ninja. Such men were masters of the local terrain, how to hide within it, and how to traverse difficult areas with relative ease. Although the shinobi were skilled at using the environment to their benefit, equal importance was placed on knowing their target's routine and patterns of behavior, for this made infiltration a far easier task. Knowledge of the enemy's regular delivery schedules, for example, often proved more significant in overcoming him than possessing his own general's plan of attack on the battlefield. Just as knowing the layout of the opponent's house could stop a conflict before it began. If conflict was unavoidable, every advantage was sought and exploited. From the mastery of secret or exotic weapons, to the use of fire and explosive devices to disrupt an adversary. But just how much of this arcane knowledge survives today? In modern times, the ninja has become almost exclusively associated with the study and practice of the Japanese martial arts, in concert with esoteric weapons, trickery, and the ubiquitous black costume. But fighting techniques appear to be at the very heart of modern ninjutsu. As common as this approach is at present, we are forced to ask, was this always true? And what about today's various ninja schools, both East and West? Have they got it right? Or are the skills and practices they teach merely a fraudulent or compartmentalized version of ancient shinobi training? To find out, we decided to ask the experts. James Loriega, based in the United States, is a respected author and martial artist. He has published countless articles on the history of the ninja phenomenon and was the special consultant for the widely popular Ninja magazine. Loriega has studied extensively with the major figures of modern ninjutsu, something he shares in common with Anthony Cummins. Cummins, based in the United Kingdom, is an avid and longtime ninjutsu practitioner. The author of several definitive books, including Shinobi Soldiers, To Stand on a Stone, and The True Path of the Ninja, Cummins is also a regular contributor to the British magazine Combat. Together, they will serve as our guides to the mysterious and fascinating world of the ninja.
So, who were the ninja? What was their function, and how were they perceived in society? Well, first of all, did the ninja exist? Yes, it is 100% that the shinobi, as they were then known, or the ninja, did exist, and that their contemporaries understood them as shinobi, or those who performed the arts of the shinobi. Today, in our society, the word ninja is almost untranslatable. It's been translated as many things, from assassin to spy. However, the only true translation is the word ninja itself. So, what is a ninja? First of all, when you think of ninja, you are thinking of the archetypal professional ninja or shinobi. However, there were also non-professional shinobi at work, or ad hoc or on-the-spot shinobi. So what we're going to talk about today is the professional or archetypal ninja, unless I otherwise state. At the top end, you've got the professional ninja, and at the bottom end, you've got a local inhabitant given money to act as a spy, and he can sometimes be known as shinobi. So make sure you understand the difference between the two, archetypal and on-the-spot ad hoc shinobi.
The ninja undertakes his missions, which may require stealth, invisibility, and perhaps even stealing something, as a mission to a greater good, never for self-benefit, but for the cause, for the clan, for the family, for the warlord that he serves. It's far and away different from the Nusubito, who is the common thief, who may still have stealth and invisibility, but does all of his sneaking around for self-gain and not for a greater good. So it was because the ninja was being taught skills that could be corrupted that they heavily invested the ninja with a high moral code to prevent against becoming underhanded and base in their motivations. The Shonin Ki, which is one of three documents that have come down to us through the ages, makes this distinction because it was in effect a ninja manual, a guideline for ninja conduct. And it distinguished between the two, and it said that the ninja practitioner had to be a shinobi no mono, a man of stealth and secrecy, and to distinguish himself always from the Nusubito, who was the common thief that everyone despised, including the ninja.
So if we're going to translate the word ninja into modern English, we'd have to have a list of words. Words such as spy, commando, shock troops, ambush troops, explosive experts, arsonist, thief, infiltration agent, and many other things like this. So as you can see, it's non-translatable. The concept of ninja has to be ninja.